what's it like for you the first time you came to New York?
I got off the plane and I had a gig in the Bowery at CBGB's. Wow. And
that's history, right? Back in the day, when
the Bowery was the Bowery. There was steam coming out of the streets and there were, you know, people panhandling on the street. It was like wild. And we did two sets, and in between sets I went down to Phoebe's, the restaurant.
Yeah.
And I had enough money for one cup of coffee. That's all I had. So I ordered the coffee, and then I finished the coffee, and the lady was pouring another. I said, no, I can't afford a second cup. She said, honey, it's America. The second cup free. I went, God bless America. I'll never look back.
When I got here, the thing that hit me the most is we went to a laundromat. And I was like, what are we doing here? And she had to take, I had to take the clothes out and fold it, and you got to put the money in. And I was just blown away by that whole thing.
Music icons Sting and Shaggy have teamed up for what might be the most unexpected collaboration of the year.
It didn't take me long to fall in love with your mind.
It may be a surprise to many, but not to them.
As we get to know each other better day by day, is how much we actually have in common. Yeah. There's a lot of commonality between the two. We're both Libras.
Yeah.
We're both married with kids, attracted to strong women.
Yeah. We both know that our women are bosses, and we say yes.
We have similar tastes in music.
Don't make me wait to love.
That similar taste in music led to their new album, 44876, named after the country codes of their native England and Jamaica. It may have their national imprints, but it was recorded right here in New York City.
If we did it in Jamaica, we wouldn't get no work done.
You wouldn't get any work done. We'd party all the time.
We'd be smoking, eating, like, you know, everything.
How did New York bring out your creative side in this album?
You know, I've always found New York to be an incredibly stimulating environment. You know, there's a drama here, there's a social drama here, there's architectural drama. It's all drama. We walk to work every day, so you're taking that in.
If you can find love.
And it's a great environment to be creative in.
This is a melting pot of culture, man. I mean, all of my hits are made here. You know, Old Carolina, Mr. Bombastic, It Wasn't Me, Angel.
So you make this album and now you're promoting the album, but you guys really look like you have a genuine friendship.
Oh yeah, this is my dude right here, man.
What's your favorite Sting song?
It would be Fields of Gold.
Will you stay with me? Will you be my love?
I got many Sting songs that I like. I mean, he's you know, he kind of knows what he's doing. Just a little bit. You know, to the tone of like 16 Grammys and over 100 million records, he knows a little bit of what he's doing. You know what I'm saying?
You ain't far behind, brother.
Yeah. Nah, still behind, though.
Yeah, you know, but that's just, okay. You're younger than me.
What's your favorite song from Shaggy?
You know what? You're making me feel good. I am younger than you.
You are?
Yeah, so I have some catching up to do.
Way.
All right, my dude, I got you, bro.
My favorite Shaggy song, it varies. Boombastic, obviously.
She called me Mr. Boombastic.
I've come to love the one about the bathroom floor. What's that?
That's the one you like the most. Stop it.
I even had her in the shower.
What is the most New York thing about each of you? You grew up in Brooklyn.
I'm Flatbush. Yeah, I'm Flatbush. I'm Flatbush when it was like Black Flatbush. Huh. Now it's like gentrified Flatbush. You know what I'm saying? It's a little bit different. It's a little different. You know what I'm saying? I love New York. I love the Caribbean community. I love Eastern Parkway, Carnival.
The Carnival, Western Indian Parade.
The Western Indian Parade.
Well, what's the most New York thing about you?
Me? I think I'm open to just about anything. I love having a citizen's rights of walking anywhere I choose, going in any bar I choose, and not be bothered or molested by people. Just, they respect you because they recognize you, but they say hi.
I'm an Englishman in New York.
So you're an Englishman in New York.
Yeah.
You're
I'm a Jamaican in New York.
Jamaican roots in New York.
So like that.
What does the city mean to you?
Everything. This is home to me now. Yeah. And if I had to choose a city exclusively to live in where they said you can't actually move, I would say, I'm happy here because everything is here.
Yeah. It's his favorite city. Yeah.
Is it really?
Yeah. Really. I can live in Paris. City. I can live in Rome. London.
He got enough money. He could live anywhere.
It's true.
Yeah. But this is where it is.
Yeah.
I love it. Loves New York. You know what? It don't matter how much money somebody is. The same guy that got a lot of money might be taking his garbage out. and you don't know. Everybody take the train. Everybody just walk around. That brings us all on a level. You know what I'm saying?
It's a great place to
it's
be.
It's a good place, yeah.
We are citizens.